भूमिर्दृप्तनिपव्याज दैत्यानीकशतायुतैः आक्रांता भूरिवारेण ब्रह्माणं शरणं ययौ। अप्रीस्ड विद स्टुपिंडस वेट ऑफ मिलियंस ऑफ डीमंस डिसगाइल्ड एज किंग्स ऑफ एक्सट्रीम एरोगेंस पृथ्वी देवी द गॉर्डियन एंजल ऑफ द अर्थ प्लेनेट सॉट टू ब्रह्मा फॉर रिफ्यूज। माय डियर फ्रेंड, परहैप्स यू रिमेंबर टू पर्सनैलिटीज हू रोज़ टू पावर अबाउट 3.5 मिलियन ईयर्स अगो। दे वर शॉट डेड इन द वॉर दैट स्टार्टेड जस्ट आफ्टर ओशन चर्निंग इवेंट। Both were resurrected by their Guru Shukracharya by Mrita Sanjeevani Vidya. One was King Bali, who integrated himself and rose so high that Lord Vishnu himself incarnated as Lord Vaman and asked for 3 steps of land, and then he measured according to his height, and he is still under his debt, and he is his helper, and he is blessed that after this Manvantara completes, he will be the 8th Indra of the 8th Manvantara and the oncoming Manvantara. The next person was Kalanemi, my dear friends. He remained a demonic. He fell so low that in order to unwind his deep-rooted violence, rage and revenge, to gain power, he did penance for 3600 years in the valley of Mandarachal. Brahmaji blessed him to be a world conqueror. He was reborn in Mathura as Prince Kans. There was no limit to his wickedness. Mathura is one of the 7 holiest townships of Bharat. Bharat means when Pakistan, Afghanistan, Burma, all the way to Bali with Tibet and Nepal and Bhutan added to India makes Bharat. Those days we were Bharatiya and our country was famous as Bharat Varsh. So, since the dawn of human civilization about 1 million years ago, it was regenerated, means Mathura city was regenerated by Prince Shatrughna, the youngest brother of Bhagawan Sri Ram. His state became famous by the name of his son Shursen, in whose reign it flourished extensively. Since last 2000 years, history records Mathura state, starting from the banks of Charmanvati River, now known as Chambal River, which hosts lots of tough robbers and dacoits, and very heroic devotee robbers, okay, and who always reel the head of the Indian governments, including the British governments. So, from Orsha to Mathura to 70 miles up to the boundaries of Kuru state, almost near Vallabhgarh nowadays, this is the area of Mathura state those days. Western boundary touched Matsya state, eastern territory touched the Panchal state. When Song, the Chinese traveler, writes in 700 AD, Mathura state extended unto 1,000 square miles. On the western bank of Yamuna River, the city of Mathura stood like a half moon of the eighth of the bright old night. In the time of Lord Buddha, it was a prosperous city which hosted him time and again. It was one of the 51 mystic power centers of Tantra of Divine Mother. Her shining long hair episode. 5,000 years ago, Mathura was much more splendorous and powerful all over the world. The destiny of nations depended upon how Mathura looks at them. Prince Ugrasen was just coronated as the king of Shusen state and waited with Princess Padmavati. The king had returned to Mathura, but queen stayed on in her parents' palace as they loved her so much. In a way, she was a fun-loving, jolly, adventurous girl. So, one evening, surrounded with her girlfriends, decorated with costliest gems, she was sporting in the royal park. Suddenly, a wicked demon, Drumil, passed that way on his airplane. He saw this beautiful girl, joyous, festive, sporting, and he thought about her, and he knew who she is. He developed a strong sexual urge. He quietly parked his airplane in a bush nearby, and assuming the form of her husband, Ugrasen, he approached her and embraced her. Her friends laughingly disappeared. So during the sex act, she knew he was not her husband. She was outraged, pushed her aside, and condemned him. But he told her that through his semen, a powerful being will be born who will be world conqueror. When her parents knew the loss of her chastity, they lamented and sent her to Mathura immediately. The accident remained concealed, my dear friends. The baby rose as the mighty Kansa. He grew fast. His body well built, muscular, stout, with tremendous strength, dressed in black suit and red suit sometimes. And with will power of the legendary Kalnemi, he grew up. Demon Kansa was preparing in the palace of Mathura to fulfill his unfulfilled desires of past life. His favorite game was wrestling, as all Mathurians still do to this day. He was just 18 years old. Those days, mighty Janasandha, the king of Girivrag, now known as Rajgiri, was on his world tour. He had camped with his army on the bank of Yamuna River near Mathura. One day, his special elephant, Kualyapid, who had equal power as 1,000 elephants, got drunk and intoxicated. He broke his shackles and ran away. He roamed into the crowded part of the city, trampling people, gardens, creatures. Panic arose, citizens ran helter-skelter, nobody dared to catch the mad elephant. Prince Kansa was jogging. He ran down and held the trunk of the Kualyapid elephant and lifted him. Shunda dande sangrihitva patayama sabhutale punargrihitva astabhyam chikshepashatayojanam. He lifted the elephant and dashed him on the ground. Not only this, he lifted him up, hurled around and threw away into his owner's camp, 1,000 feet away. It fell with a great sound in front of King Jarasandha. Shocked with surprise, he inquired about the performer of this heroic deed. He made cons and calculated his power equal to 10,000 elephant power. He was very pleased. He introduced him with his two young daughters, Asti and Prapti. Both fell in love and got married. And this Kualyapid, he gave him as dowry with 10 million gold dollars, chariots, horses, and maidens in a festive way. Father King Ugrasen was very pleased. He honored him with the post of Prince Regent and Commander-in-Chief of the Imperial Army. Filled with great pride, Kansa organized a powerful army and marched on a mission for world conquest. First, he went straight to Mahishmatipuri, now known as Maheshwar, in the bank of Narmada River, because it was his ancestral home, okay? The capital of legendary hero Kartavirya Sahastrarjun, that was the capital in ancient days. Secondly, five princes were well known for their art of wrestling with judo and karate and much more. So royal palace welcomed him. He challenged all the five iron-limbed youths, famous as Chanur and Mushtik and Koot and Shal and Toshal. The winner will be the lord and loser will be the servant, he announced. Surrounded by the swarming crowd of the citizens, they wrestled. Soon Kansa dashed Chanur on the ground and roared, and Mushtik came hitting him hard with big blows. Kansa gave him a fist fight and he fell him on the ground. The other three came, but soon they licked the dust. Victorious Kansa ordered them to work for him in his mission. Kansa's second target was mighty Dvivid. After 20 days of continuous fight on Pravarshan mountain, Dvivid was defeated. Then they came to Mount Rishyamukh. There was a fight with Keshi, who lived in the form of horse. Kansa won. Riding on him, he came to Mount Mahendra. He ripped it off and placed it back for several times. Sage Parashuram's peace was disturbed. Then suddenly Kansa saw red-eyed, enraged, blazing like a sun, Sage Parashuram. He fell prostrate at his feet and begged for pardon. Parashuram roared, "Oh, you tiny little bug, son of a bitch, you are no better than a mosquito before me. Just wait, if you can lift this bow, fine, or I shall kill you right away." He gulped and continued, "Pickle-headed, puffed-up fellow, this is the same historic bow which was given by Lord Vishnu to Lord Mahadev for Tripurasura war, which I received for the destruction of the demonic warriors, as you, son of a bitch. Now, get up and try your might." Soon Kansa tried with all his might. Look, he somehow lifted it up, all perspired. It was more than 10 feet long, but tons of weight. Still, he pulled the string, the sound shook the earth, stars fell. Kansa placed the bow carefully and bowed to the sage and said, "Holy sire, I am not a warrior, but a demon, your servant." "Okay, you are spared. By your meekness, I just pardon you. Get out of here. Take this bow. Whosoever would break it will be your death." remember this, sage said, dismissing him away. This was the greatest victory. After this, nobody intended to fight with Kansa. All kings accepted his supremacy and gave him tributes. He found python demon Agasur on the Arabian seashore. He rushed to bite or swallow him, but Kansa caught him by neck and hit him harder and hardest until he surrendered. Then he wore him like a garland, and then all the army officers welcomed him, bravo, bravo. In Bengal he battled with Arishtasura, a bull demon. He ripped off hills by his horns and hurled at Kans while he held them in space and dashed them back on him. Finally he gave him big beating with his fist. Then bull demon fainted. Stay in Mathura under my command, or I will kill you right away, said Kansa. Okay, you are the boss now on. And they were spared. Left for Bhaumasur capital. He challenged him out and he warned him too. After Pralambasur, Dhenukasur, Trinavart and Bakasur were defeated, Putana came. Kansa told her, I don't fight with a woman. I respect a woman, I adore them. Since Bakasur became my friend, you are my sister. So come with me and live in Mathura, enjoy. She agreed. Looking at the great power and generosity of this ambitious youth, Bhaumasur decided for friendship. Together with them, Kansa made a master plan for intergalactic conquest. Bhaumasur promised to join him then. Now Kansa marched further. He challenged Shambharasur, but he proposed friendship. Kansa accepted. On Trishringa hilltop, Bhaumasur was sleeping. Kansa kicked him hard. Enraged, he rose and big boxing contest began. All warriors watched this, shouted, hollered and screamed as fanatically as all sports freaks and game watchers do in every country before the television. At last, with the deafening sounds of boxing, not only watchers began to swoon, but also Bhaumasur. Then Kansa, finding his chance, jumped on him, choking his throat. Bhaumasur cried, help, help, I am surrendered. Okay, that's what I wanted. Now on, you are my servant. Okay, you are the boss, Bhaumasur agreed, sighing heavily. Kansa now moved towards Shonitpur. He met Banasur. Kansa told him, be my servant or get ready to die. Enraged, Bhaumasur dashed his foot on the earth. It went deep in and said, first lift my leg up, then you are worthy to fight. Kansa pulled it out and both began preparation to battle. Lord Shiva appeared and said, let this battle not be. You are friends belonging to the same one clan. Only some superpower can kill Kansa, who is not yet born. And Lord Shiva made them friends and vanished. Now Kansa moved towards the west. He confronted Vatsasur and warned Naradji was passing through that way. Holy sire, is here someone left on the earth worth fighting? Kansa bowed down and asked,